Welcome to Munch Class, children. In the previous class, we have completed with our exercise number 2.7. Yes. So in the previous exercise, we have completed 2.7, and in this exercise, we have learned how to arrange numbers in ascending order and descending order. So we have learned ascending order and descending order means how to arrange the numbers in ascending order. Ascending order means what? Smallest number to the biggest number. And descending order means what? Biggest number to the smallest number. So these two orders we have already learnt in our previous exercise. Okay. So today we are going to start with our exercise number 2.8. Yes. So in this 2.8 we are going to learn the forming of three-digit numbers. So for doing this exercise, you need your term book, pencil, and eraser. Okay, you need your term book, pencil, and eraser. So as soon as you take your term book, you have to open with your page number 89. Okay, so open with your page number 89 and keep your books ready and listen what I am saying here. Okay, first I will tell what is the method, what is the process you are going to do in your exercise number 2.8. So here in this exercise, we are going to do three-digit numbers. We are going to form three-digit numbers. Like in the previous exercise, we have arranged the numbers in ascending order. Yes. So when we are arranging the numbers in ascending order, what the question they give? They have formed the numbers and they have given us in your book. Yes. So here you have to form the question. Okay. So you have to form the question and you have to arrange again in the ascending order and descending order also. So how you have to arrange the numbers? See, forming three-digit numbers. Three-digit means what? You are going to have 1, 2, 3 numbers in your question. Okay. So suppose we take 2, 5, and 7. Okay. So 2, 5, 7 are the three-digit numbers. You have to form different set of numbers with only these three numbers. So how to form? See, I will tell. It is a very easy method, children. If you concentrate, you can understand it very well, and so that you can do it in your exercise also. We can solve our exercise problems also very easy. So try to understand. Yes. So sit properly, concentrate, don't divert yourself. Okay. So we have to form three-digit number, three-digit set of numbers, different set of numbers with only the three digits you have to make. So how? See, first number. They have given 2, 5, 7 I have given you. So first set of number, what it will become? See, 2, 5, 7. Simply you have to remove this comma and you have to write 2, 5, 7. It is 257. So first set of number we got. So second set of number, how you have to make? You have to make, take this one number same. See, as these numbers are three, so you can form three set of numbers with one single number. Starting with one single number, you can make three sets. Okay, three set of numbers. So this first number will be the common one. Then this 7 will come into this place. This 5 will come into this place. So here 2 already we have written. So 7 and 5. Okay. So here 5 and 7. See, 7 and 5. 257, 275. Okay. This is one set. Yes. So with one number you can make two set of numbers. One with one starting number you can make two set of numbers. So this number we have written this set and this number we have written this set. Okay. So with the one number we have finished. So take second number as your first number now. Okay. Second number as your first number. So this number we have written here. What are the two numbers left here? 2 and 7. So 2 and 7 you write it together. 2 and 7. Okay. First set of number over. So again what you will do? You will take this first number as the same number. Then you will write 2 this side, 7 this side. Okay. 2 here to this side and 7 here to this side. So 5 we have written already. 7 2 we will write. With three digits, you can make two set of numbers. You can take one as the first common number, the other number you can make zigzag, and you can make two set of numbers. So this 5 as the first digit we have taken. Now the leftover is 7. So with the 7 also we can make two set of numbers. So first you take number 7 as the same first number. Then you take the other two numbers 2, 5. So 2 and 5. So what is the number you got here? 725. 725. Then what you have to do? Again you have to make this like this 2 you have to write here. This 5 you have to write here. Okay? So take the 7, the first number, same common number. Then 5 and 2. That number this side and this number that side. Only zigzag you have to make. Okay? Now see how many set of numbers we have made. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 set of numbers we have made. Okay? With 1, because we have here only 3 digits, with 1 and 1 number as the first number, we have made 6, 2 sets we have made. So, totally we have made 6 set of numbers. Okay? These numbers again you have to arrange in ascending and descending order. Means, you have learned already in your previous class how to arrange in. Ascending order means smallest to biggest. Yes, so like in your previous class, two exercises also we have done how to arrange, how to check the numbers and how to write everything we have learned, no? Yes, so in the same way we have to arrange in ascending and descending order also. Yes, so that ascending and descending order we are going to do it in the problems, means in the exercise we are going to do it. Yes, I think you have understood how to arrange these numbers. Yes, you have understood how to arrange these numbers. This ascending and descending order from last two exercises we are doing. So, we are very much familiar with that order. Yes, so we will do it in the exercise. Okay, so with 1 as the first number, common number, we will make the other two numbers in the zigzag manner in two different places. We will take and we will form the numbers. Yes, I hope everybody is clear with this method. Now we will move into the exercise. Yes. So here in page number 89, you have first bit as make 3 digit numbers using the given digits and arrange them in the orders as indicated. So here they have given you the numbers as so here you have to form the number and arrange in ascending and descending order. Okay, here in this bit 89 page bit first bit you have to form the set of numbers and you have to arrange in ascending order and you have to arrange in descending order. So how? See A1. So here I give you homework in this bit also. So you have to be very attentive in understanding the problem. Yes, don't divert yourself. See here how I am doing. Just now I have explained in your this thing also, in the example also. Now again you have to form 6 set of numbers. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So with this 3 digits you have to make 6 set of numbers. So how to do? See first just now I said you have to first number will become the same number. You have to just remove these commas and you have to write. So 259. Next what it will become? The first number will be same. Then this number will go this side and this number will come this side. Yes. So 9595. Okay. So with the first one common number we have finished two sets. Now we will take the second number as the first number. Second number we will take as the first starting number. Okay. The other two numbers we will write as it is 2 and 9. So other two numbers we will write 2 and 9. Okay. Next what we will do? The zigzag manner. 2 will come outside, 9 will go inside. Okay. The first number will become the same number. Then 92 it will become. Okay. Now we have finished second number as first number. Second number also we have finished as the first common number. Now we will move on to the last number 9. Yes. So 9, what is 9? So this 9 you have to take first number. Then the other two numbers same. 2, 5 you have. So same way the 2, 5 you will take. 925 you got. In the second place what we will do? We will do just a zigzag manner. This 2 will go outside, 5 will go inside. So what is the number? 52. So 9 will become the same number and 5 and 2. Okay. I think you have understood. The first number will become the same number, the other numbers, the other two numbers will go in the alternate place. This place, this number will go to the other place, that number will go into the place of the next one. Okay, all the set of numbers you have to arrange like this. Okay, I hope you have understood. Yes, so now what you have to do, you have to arrange these numbers in ascending order. Okay, now you have to arrange in ascending order. See, this is the ascending order and descending order, both you have to arrange. But if you arrange the numbers in one order, the other order becomes very easy. Yes, if you arrange these numbers in one order, see, both the orders you have to make. So if you make in one order, the other order will become very easy for you to write. Yes, how to write? Yes, in the last previous two exercises also I have explained you how to arrange the numbers. So how to arrange the numbers? For arranging the numbers, you should compare the numbers. Yes, so for what is the first order? It is ascending order. So ascending order means how you have to write smallest to small number to the big number. Okay, so ascending order means always you have to pick the small number, smallest number. So how you have to do? You have to check all the numbers. See here, 2, 2, 5, 5, 9, 9. You have to check all the numbers and you have to select the smallest number. See, 2, 5, 9. So you have double numbers, 2, 2, 5, 5, 9. So from that, what is the smallest one? 2 is the smallest one. But in that 2 also you have two sets as number 2. So in these 2 sets only you have to move to the second digit. So you can leave off the other sets. Why? Because they are not smallest number, so you can leave it off. Where you have the smallest number 2, in that you go to the second digit, 5 and 9. So in this 5 and 9, which is the smallest one? 5. So your number, which number is with the number 5, the complete set will become your smallest number. So 259. Okay, so 259 is your smallest number. Next, 2, same like that, you have to check all the numbers also. So this first one is finished, so you have to leave that one, the other you have to check. 2, 5, 5, 9, 9. So from that, all what is the smallest number? 2. And here we have only one set of number with the 2. So we will write that 2 as it is, 295. See, I think you are getting the numbers same like your question. Means in how you have formed the questions, you are getting the numbers also in the same way. See, next, second 2 set of numbers over. Then move on to the next one. Okay, so smallest, ascending order means what? Smallest to biggest. So always you have to pick the smallest one. So check, 5, 5, 9, 9. So it is difficult to identify which is the smallest one, because we have 2 5s, 2 9s. From 5 and 9, we know that 5 is the smallest one. Again, in both the 5s, you have to select the smallest one. So go to the second digit, 2 and 9. So which is the smallest one? Yes, 2 is the smallest one. So your next set of number is 529. Yes, so 529 is your third set of number. Next, you see 592 means 599. You have 599. In this 599, which is the smallest one? Yes, 5. So this 592 will become your next set of number. Okay, next you have 2 9s. From this 2 9s, it is difficult to identify the smallest one. So go to the second digit, 2 and 5. So which is the smallest one? 2 is the smallest one. So your next number is 925. Okay, so and the leftover number, the last number is 952. So your last number will become what? 940. See, I think you have identified how you have arranged the numbers. Yes, so you have formed the 3-digit numbers. So in the same way, you got your ascending order also. Yes, means you have arranged the numbers in one correct order. Means that is in the ascending order you have arranged. And your ascending order also has become in the same way. Yes, so now you have to write in the descending order. Descending order means what? Smallest to biggest. Yes, so I said, you know, if you arrange in one order, the other order becomes very easy. So if you write ascending order is what? See, this is in smallest to biggest. You have written biggest to smallest, means from ulta. From last number, you have to write 950. 529, next 295, next 259. Okay, I hope you have understood this first one. Yes, so in this bit you have to do the second one as your homework. Okay, so page 89 in first bit, B1 is your homework. Okay, in term book only you have to do. Yes, I hope you have understood. You can copy this, all the numbers in your term book. Now we will move on to the second bit. See the second bit, what is the second bit? See, second bit is also in the same way, but here they did not give you these many numbers. They have given you 3 digits. Here they have given you 3 digits. You have to form the greatest number and the smallest number. Okay? So here you have to. So here they did not give you. They did not give you any numbers, alphabets for the numbers. But here I am giving you. You have to form the greatest number and the smallest number with this. When a number which when a number becomes greatest and when a number becomes the smallest. See, when a number becomes greatest, when it is having the biggest number in the first place. Okay? And always if the numbers are big in the next places, then that number becomes the biggest number. Then if the number is becoming starting with the smallest number and the next number is also small, then it becomes the smallest number. Okay? So here see 307. So first you have to form the greatest number. So you see from these all numbers which is the greatest one. 307. Which is the greatest one? 7. So 7 you have to take first. 7 over 3 and 0. Which is the greatest one? 3. So 3 you have to take. And what is the leftover number? 0. So we have to write 0. So what is the greatest number we have formed with 307? It is 730. 730 is the greatest number. Now you have to arrange in the same way. It like the smallest number. Okay? Smallest means you have to pick the smallest number. That's all. 307. See, here you have 0 also. See, in the first class, in the starting of the classes, I said where you have 0, that is not a valid number. 0 will not have any value. Yes? So you should not take 0 in the first place. So other than 0, what is the smallest one? 3. Okay? 3. 3 is the smallest one. Next, 0 and 7. Which is the smallest one? In the middle and in the second place, third place, in other places you can take 0. But not in the first place. So in 0 and 7, which is the smallest one? 0. So you take 0 in the second place. And the other number left is 7. Okay? So the smallest number we have found here is 307. Okay? So here 185. So here also 185. So which is the biggest one? 8. Second biggest one is 5. Next number left is 1. So what is the number formed? 851. Okay? So here we have to pick the smallest number. 185. Which is the smallest one? 1. Next smallest is 8 and 5. It is 5. And the leftover number is? It is 8. So 851 is the greatest one. 158 is the smallest one. Okay, in this bit, the other two questions what you have are for the homework. So here you did not have any alphabets, but I am giving the leftover problems will become your homework. Okay, I'll meet you in the next class. You can copy these numbers. I'll meet you in the next class, the next video. Thank you.